there, guys. I see Mothership checking in. So, the map I'm going to be doing here is Squadron Tower Defense. I mean, I'm sure everyone knows what a tower defense style game is, but this is a little bit different. For some reason, it reminds me of, it's the best way to put it. It reminds me of like a it's like a tower defense game, but your towers are units that move. So you're building these towers that are stationary, but they can move around. It's a really weird concept, but so you basically put them in formations that you really like, and then you can use those to defend against units, which you're there'll be units in waves, but you're playing against actually a team of four. So you're on a team of four, and you're playing against a team of four, and so you have a base that mines minerals, and I think you get gas, or might be the other way around. You get minerals, and then you mine gas, but you get kind of So you get these two different type of spawner builds. It's basically like classes. I have not played the elemental, so I'm just gonna stick with ghost because that's what I played the very first time that I played this game. You can see I'm level 11, which I'm sure is not that far considering most people. Well, it's number one on the custom games list, so you can tell a lot of people actually do play this game. So it's a very good game. I'm not totally in depth into the whole mechanics and skills of it, but I know the very first time I did, I played against people who played with people who are very skilled at the game, and against people who are really skilled at the game. So basically, like the goal is this: you spawn these towers, and they defend against waves of unit that come every wave. So I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna build two Spectres and a Wanderer. There we go. And that sort of formation. So these guys are obviously ranged, and you can upgrade your units here, and you can upgrade these as well. And he says different paths, sort of tech paths for certain buildings, but for the most part, I think you end up. I mean, they're both relatively balanced in their own way. They have their own advantages and disadvantages. So you can see here's an elemental builder. It's got different buildings, and here's a beast builder, and this guy being a ghost builder, I think, as well. No, a mechanical builder. So we got one of every type, so it's pretty cool. And with this guy, you see him mining gas here. He mines the gas, and what will happen is, let's see if I can find it over here. There's normally like units you can. It's not showing right now because of the incoming wave. Okay, I put my units completely backwards, and you can see that little. There's a little guy in there, a little zerving right there. That's a unit that people have sent. So you can send units to your opponent in order to increase the likelihood of them getting through here. And once they get through here, they come down here and fight this thing. This is your security system. Once that dies, that's it. It's the end of the game. So, is there a way to move? Oh, I didn't build it this round. That stinks. And there's a ton of, I don't know what these are. I can only assume that they are, okay, no, this is where you get the units to spawn. So you can see, these are the units you'd send to spawn. You send them with gas. You get a drone that builds. You get these little drones here. So, and every time you notice I was getting income from killing those guys, you can use them to either buy drones, which is what I'm gonna do, a worker, and they'll mine more gas, and or you can use them like I did in the first round to build more towers, basically. Which will help you get more income. Like, you don't want units to get through, because then that means that's income you're not getting for that round. And I might actually not kill everything off here. Yep, and some of these will get through, but the security system is very strong, so I wouldn't worry too much about that. So I'll kind of massing up here, and they're getting ready to, these are actually our towers, so if your towers survive the wave, they get actually teleported here to defend your security system against the guys I leaked through. So I'm gonna send, now that it's my turn, I'm gonna send a couple of marines here. I'm gonna send two marines and a fat zergling, or No, not a fat Zerglings, just a Zergling. I accidentally sent one. You did see that there was a little cooldown, so you can't just instantly spam. You do need to be slightly strategic about what you build. Now, you can upgrade the SCB speed, which will mean that they will travel faster. You see that by 40%. Now, they are moving a little bit faster, obviously, before being ridiculously slow. But I should have actually probably invested in more towers. Or as my team might start to hate me. Totally messing up the whole placement here. I wanted this guy to be in front, because I don't want the ghost to be tanking the damage. That's obviously not the best thing. I guess I should have known by that arrow there. Wow, that guy's sending a roach, man. It hit me hard. The roach might actually go down. Space cows. Pretty BA if you ask me. Dang, I let a lot through. Okay, for the next round, I'm gonna have to, I'm gonna definitely have to, build some towers. And I guess this gives you income as well by sending these, which is probably worth it to use, to send units fast. First time I played this game, I actually didn't send any units at the beginning of the game, because I didn't realize that they, I didn't realize you could send them. So, like, I got to, like, we got to a ridiculous high wave, and then some guy's like, oh, you haven't sent any units. I'm like, what do you mean? And just, yeah. That was a bad story. You know what I'm trying to say. I derped. I derped quite hard. Alright. Put that behind the zealot there. I might consider actually just selling these instead of upgrading them and moving them back, but I don't really have... I'm not in the position to be selling towers. Pee-wee looks pretty strong. I think it's just the shield, though. The shield's intimidating me. Wow, this guy's got a nice arc going. Yeah. Man, this thing's a lot harder than I remember it being. Always, they seem to be focus firing down the units that the people send before they actually focus fire these down. See them now going across here. And we have the other guys are doing a lot better than me, so they're I'm the only one who's leaking stuff. I feel this is what I mean, but I feel bad at this game. I'll send a zealot. You see him queued up here, so you can see the units that our team is sending. And as you've been seeing, like the units that they send mix in with the wave units, so it makes it a little bit more difficult to defend here. I'll build a warrior, so I can put him out in front. Aqua spirits. Oceanus. Oh no, hoverlords. Huh. Hope. Dang, dude, they're like humping my zealot. Not cool. Man, I'm like getting owned. Is everyone else? No, I'm the only one getting owned in the face. My guys are like missing and stuff. What the heck? I wish your builder could shoot, though, but I'm the only one who leaked. I feel bad at the game. Well, that'd be fair. I think I'm the only one who actually... No, okay, that guy's got workers. Whatever, maybe the ghost builder is, like, the hardest to use in the beginning. Because you get it first, I don't know. Or it could just be that I'm bad. So I do apologize, this game is going to be ridiculously long because it is a tower defense, so that means I might actually cut the video at some point and just like show you the end game sort of stuff, because at the beginning it might be kind of tedious. I'm not sure about that though. If there is, it'll probably be like right after I say this, so it'll be a nice smooth transition. It won't be like me saying that and like 20 minutes later it's like, and here's the final battle. Aren't you glad you wasted your time? But if for some reason this is a shorter game, I'll show the whole thing. I didn't build anything.
Whoops.
Aww. Dang. Oh no, that guy let some stuff through. Oh, you have to remember the security system's actually ridiculously strong. Maybe. I'm actually looking at it. But oh yeah, one thing you can do, you can actually upgrade your security system, so. Like, players can spend their in-game resources to make the security system stronger. Man, these Zergling Savages are pretty strong. I don't know. I guess I'll upgrade. I mean, upgrade what I can, I suppose. These Zerglings move so ridiculously slow. And here's my supply. Oh, so you do need extra supply in order to build, like, different, towers, so at first you'll be upgrading yours and your towers before you actually build more, unless you want to spend money on supply. That's really doing pretty good, actually. I might consider actually just upgrading more. The problem is when you're not killing these waves, you're not getting the income, which sucks. It's putting me behind so much. And here's the simple unit producer, and this is the advanced unit producer, so I can see where doors are pretty much the end game. Dang. That thing's strong. Captain. Got two of them. Oh, nice eye. Got all this gas now. I guess I could be getting income from my gas. Yeah, so because I've got these, when I send those units in the next wave, I get income, so. I'd like to say I'm making up my newbiness in extra income, but I don't think I am. I think it's just hurting me more. So I'm gonna put on another ghost just because I wanna get something out here for the next wave. It's got like this arrow going there. Put my guy in the center. He's got energy, but I wonder what he uses the energy for. You see, I feel like I should be upgrading more than I should be actually just massing units. Demolish. Ugh. Oh well. I never claimed to be a pro. In fact, I think I said the exact opposite. Whoa! Dang. Thing is beast. I only built one. I'm really afraid my team's gonna go like, "You're new! Blah, get out." Oh, you can see our wave here. Oh, our wave got destroyed, apparently. not enough. Alright, so I'm not gonna spend any more money. I'll just hold out and upgrade my units. That's what I'll do. So yeah, whenever you you send units like that, I guess it goes to your income. At which point, when the next wave comes, you get that income. And I guess it stockpiles on your previous income. Yes, I think that got in. I don't know. Level 15, exotics. So we are on wave 15. 14 minutes in. feeling stuff slowly. It'd be cool if you upgrade your units here. Actually, maybe doing a little bit better than before. Probably not. I did get up to 100 though. Oh, I probably don't want to send Zealots because it costs 20 more gas, but same amount of income, so Zealots probably aren't actually that good to send. Sorry, noob. We go upgrading. The word for me, man. The word for me. Stop upping them. Oh.
Well. Darn.
I wish you'd told me that earlier. I was one of their teammates, so we're good, we're good. It's a boss battle. Alright. I don't think I'm gonna do good. Alright. Okay, not even close. Darn, that sucks, because I'm sure he gives up money load of money. A money load of money, yeah. A big load of money, that's what I meant to say. Big hefty load of money. Watch the investors. Oh, they didn't kiss. So they're gonna kiss, but I guess I couldn't even delay it that long for them to give a nice kiss. Oh, and you see a Dream Thief there upgrading the attack level. Zeus, God of Thunder. Wow, okay. So, okay, we got three of them coming, but the security system is taking care of it. Targeting the weak. Oh, dude, are we gonna lose right here? That'd be so bad if we lost right here. Oh, the security system. She's failing. She's, oh, I think we lost. Did we lose? Oh, we lost. I take blame for that one. I would tell him I take blame, but people just get more angry if you take blame. Anyways, guys, that was a Squadron Tower Defense. There's a couple of noobs playing it. I mean, that's pretty much the gist of the game. If you get better at it, I mean, you could not suck like I did. Thanks for watching.